Hey, what's up? Jemand here to show you the four tactics of taking your exercise and your workout routine to that next level. Okay, so the first one is doing negatives. Negatives are very important. I'm going to explain to you why. The second is doing a drop set. If you're not doing a drop set, I don't know what you're doing. The third is modifying your exercise. People usually stick to doing the same exercise routine over and over. For example, they do a bench press, and they always do a bench press on the flat bench with the same weights without modifying it. They do that for years, and they don't get results from it. And the third is active rest. This is my favorite part. I usually don't take rest in between sets. If I do take rest, it's most likely an active rest. The worst thing I hate is when people sit for like 3 minutes and saying they need to recover and they need to, I just don't understand it. I can't get into it right now, but I'm probably going to write a blog about it because there's just so much into it. But active rest is going to keep your heart rate up and it's going to keep your metabolism going. It's going to get you burning calories throughout your workout. You're pretty much going to burn fat and lower your body fat percent at the same time as you're planning on building muscles. Okay, so stop sitting for 3 minutes, get your ass up, and do active rest. Alright, so we're gonna take it through I'm gonna pick 3 workouts, and I'm gonna take you through each one of them and apply the 4 tactics to each workout. I'm gonna keep it simple, it's nothing too crazy. I'm not trying to, you know, show off or anything like that, alright? Alright, so we're gonna get started.
We're first gonna start with dumbbell flies. I'm gonna grab 40 pounds, I'm gonna do a set, I'm doing about 8 to 10 reps. And I'm gonna do a negative for the last, say, 4 reps. Then I'm gonna drop it, and I'm gonna do a drop set pretty much. I use a stability ball to change up the exercise instead of doing it on a flat bench. So using the ball, it's going to engage the core. It's a little bit harder. You got to get more control. Okay, so now we're going to go into a low body exercise. We're going to go into split squats. And we're going to apply the same tactics. All right, let's go. Split squat, done on the bullshit ball. shadow box. I mean, after I did the circuit, see, most people just sit for like 3 minutes and rest. Like I said, I don't understand that. It makes no sense. People say ATP recovery, blah, 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 whatever. I usually don't rest in between sets. But when I do rest, I want to keep the heart rate up. I mean, the shadow boxing, or working the back, going for a minute. See, my muscle still gets to be popping. This is actually good for the muscle because I'm getting blood flowing to the muscle. All right? Keeping the heart rate up. Once I'm done with this, I'm gonna go back and do 3 more sets. Wow.